heels in here, I'm going to marvelous at the Paracas Museum in Peru, checking out this incredible collection of elongated skulls. This is the first case. You can see the huge jawlines, red hair. Large eye sockets. This here is an exact replica of a child that was found with the skull there on the left. And it actually had strawberry blonde hair when they discovered it. Here's the second case. You can still see some hair and skin almost on this one. Huge jaw. And this one has the most skin, I think, of all of these elongated skulls in the museum. And the red hair. Okay, here is the third case. Four skulls. I got this one here. We've got two humanoid looking skulls. We've got pretty well-known skull here, many call it the Star Child skull. Check out the holes in the back of the head. And the parietal plates and sucurines are different than conventional human skull. And there again is the holes. And then let's go over to the big exhibit. Got a bunch of skulls in here. We'll go from left to right. Again, the holes. Lots of skin on that one. This one here in the middle is a human skull of a farmer. He put it in here so that we could visually compare it to the elongated skulls.
Oh my God, he's about to die.
Recent DNA analysis on some of these has come back stating that cranial volume is up to 30% more and 60% heavier. 30% more in mass and 60% heavier than a normal conventional skull. So it couldn't have just been from cranial deformation.